Now we are going to learn about the very lightweight simulator, Turtlesim. It provides all the basic functionalities of ROS2 that a beginner needs to learn. So open up your terminal. In order to install the Turtlesim, you first need to update. So now you can install this package using sudo apt install ROS at distro foxy and Turtlesim. So this is the command to download or to install a package in ROS based workspace. First we type sudo apt install and then the ROS as distro evert foxy, then we will write foxy. If it's humble, then we will write humble and then the package name. So let's give it a try. It is installed and now we can find out the executable files in this package. ROS2 package execute table Turtlesim. So it has given us a list of the nodes that we can utilize. So let's first write ROS2 run Turtlesim node. So a window appears. So this is the first simulator that we utilize to learn the basic ROS concepts. We can move our turtle around, play with the several parameters and services. So open another terminal and we are going to control it. ROS2 run Turtlesim turtle_tail keys. Okay, so it has created a node that can move the turtle around. So you can press forward, backward key, right to rotate it to right, left to rotate it to left, right and left. So you can play with it as it moves, it draws a line. It's pretty fun to play with it. And you can also use these letters to rotate it to absolute orientation. So let's press G and P, C and D. You can play with it. And F to cancel the rotation. So if I press like G, and then suddenly I press F, it will stop right there. To quit this node, we can press Q. We are going to see the node list. ROS2 node list. So we currently have one node that is Turtlesim. And we can also see the topics. ROS2 has topic list. So these are the topic. Currently, I know you do not understand the topic and nodes and services parameters, but wait, you will learn them in the next lectures. You just get an idea. And ROS2 service list. And these are a bunch of services that this node contains. And ROS2 action list. So it has also an action. Now we will install the RQT. RQT is a tool that will allow you to monitor, subscribe, or publish onto a topic, and it will even allow you to call services. To install this tool, we will just copy this command and paste it here. Enter your password. It will just update the system. And now, So now the tool is installed. We can type RQT and it appeared. So it is showing me the topics. We can monitor them and the message type of the topic and the value. So currently we are not monitoring any of the topic. So let's click here. So this command velocity topic has several values in it. Currently there's no data being published on this topic. I will just open another terminal. Okay, ROS2 run Turtlesim Turtlesim_tellyup_key. Yes. Drag it down and move the turtle around. So here you can see it gets the data and the frequency. This is how you can monitor the topic on RQT. Now no data has been published on this topic, so it is giving us no frequency, but if I move the board around, it will give us some value of frequency. It also shows the X and linear X and rotational Z that we give it using the tally operation. Let's just uncheck this topic and let's check the pose of the turtle. Move the turtle around. It is giving us the value of the pose of the turtle in the Turtlesim window. This is the frequency, more than 62, and the value of X and the theta. Let's just play a little bit more. So as you can see, it is changing its pose as I move it around in the window. So now we will try to call some services. Uncheck this topic and go to the plugin and select service caller. So here we have the service caller. Okay, here it is the service that is clear. We have a list of other services that we can utilize, but let's just select clear and call. So it has finished all the lines that were on the window. Let's again move it around and we will see the line. Select the service reset and call. So it will just reset our window. Turtle wants set pen. Here are a bunch of arguments that it needs to know. And we will like set it to 255 and give it any random value less than 255. This is RGB value. And the width, let's increase it to 4 and call. So the service is called. And yeah, here you can see the difference. So now let's call another service, that is spawn. I selected the service spawn and it is asking what is the value of X, Y, theta and the name of our new turtle that will be spawned in the window. Let's say 2 and 4 and the name call. Here is our the second turtle. But if I try to move, I can only move one turtle, that was turtle 1. I cannot move to turtle 2 with this telio. Now let's check the topics. Now we have turtle 1 and turtle 2 topics. And we can also see some extra services that are related to turtle 2 and turtle 1. So here is the command to move the second turtle as well. Okay, this is the command to move. So ROS2 run Turtlesim turtle_tellyup_key minus minus or dash dash ROS, ROS minus art. This keyword will let the ROS know that the user want to specify an argument. And what is the argument? The argument is the remap. And remap what? I want to remap turtle 1 CMD. Well, 2 turtle 2 CMD underscore well. So why am I doing this? The default topic for this node is turtle 1 slash CMD well, but we have another turtle that has turtle 2 CMD well topic. So I will just hit enter and try to move. And here you can see the turtle 2 is also moving, and we can also move turtle 1 as well. That must be a very exciting experience for you. So you have learned to choose the turtle sim. You have monitored a topic on RQT, and you also called several services related to turtle sim. So that was it.